Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show on Legends 100.3, the place to fine-tune your swing, dress for the course, club, or cruise, and get tips on the best places to play and stay at the right price. Vacation or staycation, host Dan Shoub, along with his expert guests, will tell you where to go to play golf and vacation, that is. Now, here's Dan.
Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show. I'm your host, Dan Shoub. And this morning, we're going to talk some golf. We're going to talk some travel. I've got some incredible deals on travel, which are becoming more and more difficult to find. But I'm doing it for you. So somebody's got to do the heavy lifting. It may as well be me. And, of course, joining me this morning from Legends Radio, we've got Mike McGann. How you doing, Mike?
I am outstanding, Dan. How are you today?
I'm doing great.
I really like that shirt.
Oh, thank you.
I mean, he's got, it's a great shirt, and it's got the Golf and Travel Show logo, and I love it because it's kind of the earth as a golf ball with an airplane going around it. It really captures the branding beautifully.
Thank you, and long sleeves as I'm heading north, going to be traveling to New York and then Tampa and Sarasota. So next week I'll fill everybody in on some of my travels and the good, the bad, the ugly, like I like to do.
Yes.
Some of the ugly happened already, and I'll talk about that when we talk more about travel. So, because setting some of these things up is not always easy, but if you remind me, when we come back from our next break, I'll talk a little bit about the hassles of setting up travel.
Oh, yeah, smart.
But let's talk a little golf first. Congratulations are in order. Last week's winner, match play, which is different, the Dell Technologies, went to Scottie Scheffler, and he is on fire. He has had a meteoric rise to the top of the world rankings, number one. 3 wins in 6 weeks is what did it for him.
Wow.
And, yeah, he's... amongst the youngest people to have ever made it to number one. Ahead of him as being a little younger, he's just under 26 years old, but doing it at younger ages than him would be some pretty elite company. We're talking about Tiger Woods, Jordan Spieth, Rory McIlroy, Justin Thomas, Jon Rahm.
Wow.
Yeah. So
that's very...
like out of nowhere to the elite of the elite. So congratulations to him. Of course... you know, that was his prep for the Masters, which is coming up this week. So we'll talk about that a little more in a second. When they do have these invitational events like the World Golf events where the best players play, they allow the other players sometimes to play the second division, I guess we could call them, in another event. And last week they played the Corrales Punta Cana Championship, a beautiful golf course. I have had a chance to play. And not surprisingly, at the top were competing for the win three players that are not kind of roll off the tip of your tongue names. Alex Smalley, Ben Martin, and the eventual winner, Chad Ramey, for the first time winning on the PGA Tour. So congratulations
to
him.
Sure, that the three, yeah.
Yeah, but it's an opportunity.
That's the thing. I love that about it.
There's so much that's so little that separates the best players in the world from like the next 100 or two.
Yeah.
You know, usually it's in their head. You know, they all have the skills to make it to where they've made
it.
It's
really what it is.
Yes, the difference between winning is just putting it all together and maintaining that focus.
When they rise up, there's nothing like that.
It's nice. And another first-time winner on the LPGA Tour in Carlsbad at the JTBC Classic was Athaya Thitikul, and her first win as well. So congratulations to her. Finishing up a little bit later today, we've got the Valero Texas Open, and for some people, that is the final tune-up for the Masters and the final chance for somebody who has not been invited. If you're not invited to the Masters and you win later today, you'll get invited. So, boy, will your life change dramatically. The defending champion, Jordan Spieth, is showing up, as well as a large group of top-ranked players. The Valero Texas Open is just very popular. The players like to support it. Also, the Champions Tour are playing at the Rapiscan Systems Classic. That'll also be finishing up later today in Biloxi, Mississippi. And the women are finishing up a little bit later because they're on the West Coast. The Chevron Championship in Rancho Mirage. And that is pretty cool, as that used to be the Dinosaur.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yes, it is the last time being played at Mission Hills Country Club. A long, long run there. So there's a little bit of sadness as well. You know, it happens. They got to move on. But it's the first major of the year for the women.
Right.
So, and of course, the winner gets to jump into the poppy pond or whatever that is, that's tradition that they have. And I think the defending champion, Patty Tavitanikit, last year dove in and then had to realize that she doesn't know how to swim. So luckily, I don't think it's that deep and they don't jump so far. And sometimes some of the other players jump in with them. And so hopefully no lives are lost.
I really hope there's video of that incident because I need to track it down and I'm going to need the spelling of her name.
Also at this event, the last time announcing the major, she still will kind of be semi-retired and do a little announcing here and there. But Judy Rankin, of course, a great LPGA tour and her player in her own right, and then went on to a great announcing career. So congratulations to her and her semi-retirement. Also, I guess you didn't see this video, but in this past week, there was a at halftime of a Portland Trailblazers game, a guy had the opportunity to putt on the court from one end to the other.
That's a pretty impressive
putt. For $50,000, he sunk it.
Wow.
I mean, who? How do you judge the speed of a putt? I mean, we talk about the Masters in Augusta, it being like putting on the hood of a car.
Right.
Because this, you know, is so fast. But I mean, I don't know. Maybe he got a practice swing or two. But, you know, who knows how it's going to break and the speed and everything
else. That's the thing. I mean, was the court like freshly waxed? There's a lot of variables on that.
Yes.
And, I mean, at least you don't have to take wind into account. You're not going to have a huge break left or right. But the smallest
straight as
thing,
an arrow right in the hole. And, of course, the crowd just goes crazy.
As they should. That guy should be a physicist.
Exactly. Also on the LPGA, they changed their Hall of Fame criteria because Lorena Ochoa, who belongs there, could not get in because they had a requirement of 10 years and she played only 7. And then decided to retire early.
Oh.
So certainly deserves to be in. She'll be going in along with the 8 remaining founders of the LPGA who have not made it in yet. So the founders will now be in. It was founded in 1950. There's only one still alive, Shirley Spork. So congratulations to all of them. Also, local news. I know we're running a little late for our break, so let me just get this one story in, and then we'll talk a little golf on the other side. But Florida Atlantic softball coach Joan Joyce, okay, she's the only coach in the program's 28-year history at FAU. She died this a week ago at 81, but she was also a professional golfer too.
Okay.
So crazy. So not only an incredible softball player, softball coach, but incredible golfer. 19 years she spent as a member of the LPGA Tour.
19 years.
One round in 1982, she took only 17 putts.
Wait,
there's 18 holes.
18 holes.
Only took 17 putts. She had an illustrious career, so she will
incredible.
Certainly be missed. And, of course, right, you know, from here in Palm Beach County.
I mean, that's over 100% on the green.
Yeah.
That's
yeah, so obviously she sunk something from off the green and maybe more than one from off the green.
Maybe 17 of them, and they just had a really bad time.
A lot
time.
Of one putts, yeah. I mean, just crazy statistics. So.
That's wild.
All right, so what we're going to do is take a very quick break, and then we'll be back with a tiny bit more golf news, some travel news, and some incredible deals on travel. You won't want to miss it, so please stay tuned for more of the Golf In Travel Show.
Best thought of the day is to use the Texas way.
Hi, Golf and Travel listeners. It's Dan Shube here with a message for your retirement. Golf and retirement go hand in hand, and when looking for a retirement advisor, trust and experience are two qualities to look for. And my friend, Jupiter Joe Thomas, possesses both of these. Whether you're in retirement or looking to retire, give local expert Joe Thomas a call at 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999. Or go to JupiterJoe.com. That's JupiterJoe.com. Mention my name, Dan Shube, and receive a free copy of Joe's book, Retirement Know-It-All. After I read his book, I became a client. His advice has allowed me to sleep easy and not worry about retirement. Phone again is 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999. Or just go to JupiterJoe.com. That's JupiterJoe.com. Easy, right?
It went straight down the middle. Then it started to hook just a wee, wee bit. That's when my caddy lost sight of it. That little white pellet has never been found to this day. But it went straight down the middle, like they say.
And we are back, and a little leftover business in the golf world. How about a little Masters talk since it's coming up this week? Of course, the Golf Writers Association annual dinner is on Wednesday. I never go. That may change next year because of my retirement
yes,
from
you'll
my
have
day
some
job,
time.
So I'll have more time. So maybe I'll go up there. On Wednesday, in addition to the Golf Writers dinner, is, of course, the Par 3 tournament that everybody looks forward to. Of course, a lot of the players play with their kids, people like Tiger Woods, and we'll talk about him in a minute. But one kind of sad note is our neighbor just up the road, the other neighbor besides Tiger Woods, Jack Nicklaus,
yes.
is not going to be playing. He announced
oh,
he will not play. He's just too old to even play in the par three any longer. But he is looking forward to the ceremonial first ball. He certainly has enough left in his bag to hit just one shot, basically. So Tom Watson, of course, will be playing, and Gary Player, of course, will also, all three of them will be hitting that ceremonial shot. So that's good to know. Tiger Woods, we assume, might play in the par three, maybe with his son. But he might play in the tournament, which is craziness because he has not taken his name out. He's still on the list of players. He took a practice round in walking. So there's a lot of rumors that Mr. Woods could be back and playing in the Masters, the scene of some of his greatest triumphs and some of the greatest triumphs in the history of golf. So it could be another incredible comeback for Tiger. The whole world, the Tiger world, the golf world is waiting with bated breath to see what happens. So we'll talk about that some more
yes,
next week
exactly.
when we know what happens. So,
yes.
So that's what's going on in the world of golf. The world of travel, as I alluded to earlier, it's getting more and more difficult to find deals, okay? There's a lot of reasons because as COVID tends to wind down, although it may be coming back again, but most countries are dropping all of the requirements for, you know, being vaccinated or tested, you know,
right.
before and after and everything else. So more and more pent-up demand is being released. And as people book more flights, the prices go up. And not to mention the cost of fuel.
Yes.
Of course, it affects airfare tremendously, but it affects everything. It affects hotels, too. As a matter of fact, I forgot, just reminded myself, so I need to talk about that, too, about my hotel experience. But we'll talk about that in a second. So a website or an app, I guess, Hopper, which is used to find cheap airfares, they did some research on their site where people book, and it seems that airfares, since the beginning of the year, the average airfares are up 40%.
Wow.
So, yeah, there are great deals to be found, but you got to dig deeper, and it has to be where you want to go. So, I mean, if you're flexible, you can still find a deal, but if you need to go to a certain place, it may cost you significantly more than it has in the past 2 years or so. So the average round-trip ticket, according to Hopper right now, is $330, 7% above what it was in 2019.
Oh, wow. That's massive.
And again, it's inflation. I mean, remember, everything is up 7 or 8%. So why would airfare be any different? But expect it to go even higher because of the cost of fuel. And of course, President Biden announced this past week that he's releasing 1 million barrels a day from the strategic reserves. Hopefully that will help a little bit, but it's not a long-term solution. So we'll have to keep an eye on it. Stay tuned here if you're looking for good deals, because I'll tell you about them.
Yes.
And also, maybe as a way to try and offset this, it seems that just recently there was a Airbus A380 that is took a test flight, a three-hour flight from an airport in Toulouse, France, and it was fueled using cooking oil and waste fats.
That's fascinating. I actually love to hear that because it's so...
I mean, I've driven behind vehicles on the road that are doing that, and it smells like, you know, McDonald's French fries when you're driving behind them.
And
because
that's
it may
not
have been
the worst thing in the world.
Right. So it's happening maybe to airplanes now. So I think that's quite fascinating. So we'll see how that all works out. What I wanted to say was is that I was booking some hotels via Hilton. And I am a Diamond member of the Hilton Honors program now. So I used,
right.
So I booked two nights, you know, one night in Tampa and one night in Sarasota for this business trip. And I booked them using their app, and I took the cheapest rate that they had, which is a non-refundable rate.
Okay.
2 days later, I realized that I switched the two dates, the two nights. So I had to switch them, you know, from a Tuesday in Tampa to, you know, whatever. So I call up the dedicated line for the Diamond Honors members, their best customers that they have. And, oh, yeah, we'll help you. Oh, no, I see by your rate there's nothing we could do. Sorry. And I said, well, I'm your best customer. I said, I'm not looking for a refund. I just want to switch the 2 days, you know, from a Tuesday to Wednesday. The rate should be the same.
Not looking for a refund, just an adjustment.
Yeah, you know, it's only two. I can't help you. I said, well, can I talk to a manager? They get me a manager on the phone. I go through the whole thing again, same thing. I said, well, I'm also the host of the Golf and Travel Show, and I'm going to talk about this on the air. Do you think you can help me now? Oh, yes, sir. We can help you now.
Wow. I'll tell you, Dan.
So they did help me, but kind of like when you change a flight like on Southwest where they allow you to do it, you then have to change to the then current rate. 2 days later, one of the nights went up $40. The other went up $80. Over $300 to stay at a basic motel on a weeknight in Tampa
and
or Sarasota.
Just make a minor change to it. That's,
yes.
Man, I was thinking I need to play the celebrity card more, but maybe not.
Yeah, it's, you know, again, just be careful, you know, when you make your reservations. You know, we all want to get the least expensive deal, whether it's a hotel or whether it's an airline. We all make mistakes sometimes. And when you do, it can be very, very, very costly, especially like on the ultra economy airlines, you know, your Spirits, your Frontiers,
sure.
Things like that. If everything goes perfect, you can get a good deal. But if any tiny little thing goes wrong, you're going to pay like crazy to try and fix it. So, you know, even if you screw up once every 10 times, you're probably better off just paying the extra rate, you know, another $20, $50, whatever, and having, you know, a hotel room or an air ticket that is adjustable if things happen. You know?
That makes sense. I mean,
just saying, again, even I make mistakes, as careful as I try to be. And again, I always share with everybody the good, the bad, the ugly. Learn from other people's mistakes so that you don't make them yourself. So that's why.
You make very few. So it's good to learn from the ones
very,
you do.
Very, very few. Unfortunately or fortunately, this was for my day job. So they're going to have to pay for it. They're not going to make me pay. But I've probably saved them $1 million on airfare and hotel deals for the 15 years that I've worked there. So, you know, this $100 mistake or so they're going to have to eat, unfortunately. But I still feel bad because I don't like to waste a penny, and I don't want any of our listeners to waste a penny either. So listen to us. Finding deals are more and more difficult. But in the next segment, I've got some amazing ones for you. You won't want to miss it. So stay tuned for more of the Golf and Travel Show.
You better step aside. A lot of men didn't. A lot of men died. I hook it to the left. A shank it to the right. I'll be looking for my ball until the dark of the night. You play 18 holes.
Hi, Golf and Travel listeners. It's Dan Shube here with a message for your retirement. Golf and retirement go hand in hand. And when looking for a retirement advisor, trust and experience are two qualities to look for. And my friend, Jupiter Joe Thomas, possesses both of these. Whether you're in retirement or looking to retire, give local expert Joe Thomas a call at 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999. Or go to JupiterJoe.com. That's JupiterJoe.com. Mention my name, Dan Shube, and receive a free copy of Joe's book, Retirement Know-It-All. After I read his book, I became a client. His advice has allowed me to sleep easy and not worry about retirement. Phone again is 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999. Or just go to JupiterJoe.com. That's JupiterJoe.com. Easy, right?
Are back, and as I kind of hinted before the break, I've got some incredible deals. They're harder to find than ever, but I'm working harder, so that I can share them with all of you so that you don't have to do all the work. So this deal, before I even spoke about it on the radio, we already have people here at the station that want to do it. So.
I was watching that conversation. I was cracking up. I'm like, that's madness right there.
Yeah, this one is hot. I found this on Travelzoo. You got to book it pretty quick because you have to book it by, I think I had said, April 6th. So you only got a couple of days. But this is an all-inclusive package to Mexico. And some of the places in Mexico these days, there has been some crime, you know, some of these drug cartel things going on in places like Cancun. And this does require a flight into Cancun, which is part of the package. But then you're going to have to get transported north to an area that's probably a little safer and a little more interesting, which is Tulum. You know, they've got great things to see like pyramids and other stuff besides just hanging out at your all-inclusive. But what intrigued me about this is it happens to be a Hilton. We were just talking about Hilton, so be careful.
Yes.
But it's a package through Great Value Vacations found on TravelZoo.com for a brand new Hilton. It's not even open yet. It opens in mid-May. And beginning in May, you know, again, because they want you to get these great deals because it's hard to fill a hotel when it's brand new. And, of course, there's always the risk that there's construction delays and you may have to rebook. But I'm sure they'll allow you if they do it. But this is just crazy. This includes airfare from Fort Lauderdale or Miami, three nights at the brand new Hilton Tulum Riviera Maya all-inclusive resort. It's for a nature view room, but for about $75, you can upgrade to an ocean view. I'm going to show you this ocean view from the lobby, Mike, just so that you could comment on it.
Oh, good Lord.
Okay, crazy, right? So even if you don't have the ocean view, you could just walk to the beach and get it.
That is stunning. The design and the layout, that's
brand
amazing.
New.
Like, I feel zen looking at
it. It is brand new. It's gorgeous. So three nights, unlimited meals, drinks, including liquor, all taxes, all fees, all airfare for the second half of May, as little as $599 a night per person. That goes up in the fall, September, October, to $699. Other dates, $799 June or August or November and December. They also have deals into 2023 that are more, but obviously it's brand new. They have nothing booked there yet, so they need to get people. So if you're willing to try something new, there's no reviews. It's new. But I like new. I mean, new is nice,
it's
right?
It's a nice thing.
It's a wonderful thing. And of course, if you're like me, if you're a member of Hilton Honors, now when you book in this package, you may not get credit on Honors, but of course, anything else that you charge to your room, you will get. They may at least give you credit for nights stayed, which is another component besides money spent. So who knows? You might be able to get some benefit if you're a member of Hilton. And of course, like I said, you do need to book this by April 6th. So you only have a very, very short amount of time. Oh, Go to TravelZoo.com. Check it out. Also on TravelZoo.com, I shared this with one of our listeners, a friend of mine, John Kay, different John Kay than the one from my day job. He's planning a trip to Greece in September. I found this, again, on TravelZoo through Exotica. They're very well-respected. We've had them on the show before.
Right.
This includes Athens as well as many of the islands, places like Paros, Santorini, and more. It is nine nights of hotel with air. Air from Miami, I believe, all your ground transportation, one dinner, all your guided tours, English-speaking guide, three nights in Santorini, two nights in Paros, one night in Kalambaka, I don't even know where that is, and three nights in Athens, decent hotels, you could always upgrade. It does include breakfast every day, starting at $15.99 per person.
Oh, okay, wait a minute. It's Athens and the Greek islands, okay? It's nine nights.
Yeah.
There's breakfast every day.
Yes.
All the amazing things you talked about.
Yes.
The view I can see on that picture from here, which is unreal.
Yeah, so it's under
and
$200.
Airfare.
Yeah,
and
under
airfare.
$200 per night per person, but with airfare, some meals, lodging. I mean, crazy. So, I mean, I've always wanted, I mean, it's a bucket list for me is to go to Greece. So, and it is for John, so maybe it should be for you too.
That's an amazing,
again,
nine nights.
You have like a week or so to book this. April 9th is the deadline to book this. Do it. I mean, I wish I could do it. I can't
I do
everything, but
I would go immediately. I can never get time off, but if I could, I'd go.
Exactly. Now, airfare only deals. Go to googleflights.com and you can find these. Put in where you're leaving from, where you're going to. Do it by month. You'll see the days that have these incredible deals because it's not every day. It's not every month.
Right.
From Fort Lauderdale to Charleston, wonderful place to go. I love it. Nonstop, round trip, $158. Now, you could drive there, but it's a pain in the ass to drive there.
And,
so
and with gas prices being what they are right now, it's probably cheaper to fly.
Yeah, maybe this is with the oil from the French fries. Maybe that's how they have it so cheap. I don't know.
Now, but that's a possibility.
Who knows? But it smells good. It just makes you hungry.
You're right. It's good for the restaurant business in Charleston.
Exactly. And the restaurant business is awesome.
Oh, it's crazy.
In Charleston. I mean, it is the number one town in America, I believe, to go to, and certainly if you're a foodie, number one, cannot be beat. How about the West Coast? I'm heading out there in May. I will be out in that area, a little bit north of this area, Los Angeles from Orlando, nonstop round trip, $178.
To L.A.?
To L.A., yeah.
And that includes time travel.
Yeah.
Going across time travel.
Of course. And this is on American, Delta, or United, so it's not, you know, Frontier or Spirit. So
right.
Do it. Panama City, Panama from Orlando, nonstop round trip, $222. Not bad. On Delta.
Again, I love Delta.
Delta's a great airline. I recommend them.
Always love
them.
At
this price, do it. Colombia is on sale from Miami. As little as $182 nonstop round trip. Actually, it's even cheaper to Cali, $156 nonstop round trip. Medellin, $153 nonstop round trip from Miami. And you can go to anywhere else there for about $50 on their internal flight. So
right,
if you
can hop just from one to the other.
Right, so what I would do is I would fly to Medellin for $153 and then fly from there to Bogota and to Cartagena, you know, and see like the key places there for a pittance.
What?
I mean, Colombia is beautiful
incredible.
And safe these days.
Yeah,
it's not like the old days with the cartel.
Except for the hippos. That
yes. how about England? Round trip from Orlando, $457.
To England?
Yeah. Not a bad
that,
deal.
How is that under $2,000?
Or to Nice or Paris, $451 to Paris round trip from Miami, or Nice $464 round trip from Miami.
I got nothing.
These are
on
crazy
that.
Deals. Thanks to our sponsor, Retirement Network Advisors, Jupiter Joe Thomas. Not just a friend, he advises me. Thank God he does, because I'd be in big trouble without him. You can be helped by him too. Go to jupiterjoe.com, tell him I sent you, and ask for his free book, and you will be as smart as I now am, and hopefully as smart as he is. He will help you. Go to facebook.com/ The Golf and Travel Show. Like the page, and then you'll know who our guests are going to be on upcoming shows. And, of course, next week I'll talk about some of my travels. You won't want to miss it, so tune in again next week for another episode of The Golf and Travel Show. In the meantime, hit them straight.
Thanks for listening to The Golf and Travel Show, hosted by Dan Shoup. Dan's here every Sunday at 7 a.m. to help you hit 'em straight, whether you're in Palm Beach County or traveling around the world. We'll see you next Sunday morning for more of The Golf and Travel Show right here on Legends 100.3.